scene. They were able to quickly go in, apprehend him, and bring him back out and into custody. They have him in custody now and will, of course, be questioning him. They are talking to other people that were in that building right now and really trying to determine who's going to take the lead on this investigation. Like I said, it's federal property. This is in the city of Millington, but it's a state building. So they said that City of Millington Police, along with NCIS, will be working this investigation, trying to determine exactly what led up to these shooting events. We are hearing different reports about what might have happened coming up to this, whether this was a disgruntled employee that went out to his car and got his gun and came back. We are still sorting through those details to find out exactly what happened. The chief of police says she didn't know for sure. They were investigating at this time. But again, two people taken to the med. They were taken in critical condition, expected to be okay. One shot in the foot, the other in the leg, after a shooting here at the Army National Guard building right across from the Naval base here in Millington. Of course, we'll continue to bring you the latest right here from Millington. Live in Millington, Candace McCowan, WREG News Channel 3.
So Candace, we know as a precaution, the Naval base and other facilities, even a nearby school, were put on lockdown. That has all been lifted, correct?
Right. Yes, that was lifted shortly after we got here on scene. We could hear the loudspeakers as we were driving by a nearby golf course and the naval base. They were telling everybody that the lockdown was lifted, that they could resume their normal activities. But they were on lockdown for quite some time here as they tried to sort out exactly what was going on. Millington police says they were headed into this situation expecting to come in contact with an active shooter here on scene, and that it was good news that once they got here, that shooter was actually already taken down by people in that building.
All right. Thank you very much, Candace, for that report. I guess later on, maybe we will find out or possibly find out what the motive was in that shooting. Our Stephanie Scurlock, of course, is covering the other scene, which is the med where the two victims of today's shootings were taken. Stephanie.
Well, Claudia, it was never a chaotic scene here at the med. Things always seem pretty calm, but we were here as those two ambulances came down Jefferson here and into the med's holding area where they eventually unloaded those victims out of the ambulances. Again, as we said, it was pretty much a controlled situation, and we could tell that it probably wasn't life-threatening injuries, and that is, of course, the case this afternoon. We were there as they unloaded the first victim. He appeared to have a blanket over his leg, which we now learned that he had been shot in the leg, and they got him out first, and then they unloaded the second victim out of the other ambulance, and it appeared that his foot had blood on it. It was wrapped in some kind of white bandage, and we could see that as they were taking him inside the mud, in the med, that is. Now, both are National Guardsmen, as we have been told, and so was the alleged shooter. Again, their injuries are not life-threatening, and that is a good thing and the good news that we are hearing here. One shot in the foot, the other in the leg, and it appears that they're going to recover. Reporting live from the med, Stephanie Scurlock, News Channel 3.
And not surprisingly, Stephanie, all three men were in uniform, as you could tell there, during the course of this shooting.
And as we've seen, you know, in the past, it could have ended so much worse. Could have been ended very badly. But again, we are so glad that the two victims are in non-threatening condition.
So now we want to hear from an official spokesman for the Navy, who also addressed reporters. Let's listen into what he had to say earlier today.
We're working hard on it. Obviously, families are always going to remain our priority. We want to make sure information is shared with them in a timely manner, but that's why we have the responsibility to put out accurate information, and we're working on getting that, and as we get additional clarification, we will be certain to push that out.
And some of the information we're still needing to know, of course, is a confirmation on the motive and also the identities of the three men who were involved in the shooting.
And the Millington police do have custody of the alleged shooter at this time. And, of course, we will keep you updated right here on News Channel 3.
Thanks for joining us, and stay here for further reports.